New Zealand used to be rich with gold, but as far as most of us know, the old timers cleared it out many years ago.
But those in the industry know there's still plenty there, and now 160 years later, with new technology and a record high gold price, the New Zealand gold rush is back on. Julian Lee reports.
If you want to find gold in New Zealand, this is the spot, Central Otago. The hills are teeming with it. It's like playing lotto, except for free. All you need is time, and a pan, of course.
You'd be going up the river, so you'd start at the bottom, and you're looking for colour, so looking for a little bit of gold in your pan, and you just keep going up.
Oh, so just pure trial and error, basically?
Pure trial and error. So it's a good fertile rock that you might find structures that might have the fluid, that might have the gold.
It might, there's a lot of whites.
Yeah.
An outrageously high gold price is causing a steep climb in gold prospecting applications to the government.
How much would that bit there be worth, do you reckon? Just this little bit here?
$2,000.
It's about as heavy as a nail.
A lot of areas where we knew there was gold, but the gold wasn't economic to mine. With the increase in the gold price, it now is economic to mine.
Annie works at Macraes, New Zealand's largest gold mine. Being in gold, naturally, she's got a yarn.
So a few years back, we had a major flood come through the Deep Dow Creek, and it took the culvert out. With the flood, the old truck went down the creek, and we lost three bars, found two, but one is still missing. One of these days, Julian, you might just find it one of these days. If you're in a flow of the water, you can use the water to take that part away, and then you'll see your gold flakes sitting on the edge. What have you seen? Have you found the bar? We got
you. You did get me, yeah. Is it actually true?
No.
Do you have six?
I have six.
I've got two. Oh, I was just too hardcore.
My gumboot's also full of water.
Many of the new claims in this area are for river or alluvial mining. But at Macraes, they aren't panning, they're extracting from hard rock.
Those old timers wouldn't have the technology to be able to extract it. We now do, so that was only developed in the late 80s and 90s. So it allows us to mine with a pretty minimal impact on the environment.
We've definitely come a long way since this setup over here, eh?
This is the kind of technology we're talking about. Dindo shows us around. Rocks are ground down and down and down and down and down with machines and chemicals until you can't even see them. And the end game is this room, a room whose location is top secret, where this happens. All that effort, all that work, the prospecting, the drilling, the plant, the machinery, it all comes down to this. Over $1 million worth, just like that. Today, David and Reese have poured $3.5 million. Apparently, it's a quiet day at the office.
All the stuff must run through your head, like the value of gold, why we value it so much. You must have a million thoughts up here.
Not really. I worry more that I pour it and it comes out in one piece.
The gold dust on the floor alone, which they vacuum every day, is worth maybe $100,000 a month.
How much would that be, a dog? As heavy as a dog?
It's like as heavy as a sack of potatoes.
Where are you buying your potatoes?
Yes.
Car battery.
A
car battery.
Two bars, 8 kilograms maybe?
Two 8 kilogram bars, like a really heavy pot plant. About 76 apples. It's a lot of apples. And that is worth how much?
$1.2 million.
$1.2 million right there. None came off on the fingers. Oh yeah, a little bit. No, nothing.
The New Zealand gold rush is back. And only those with the luck, the know-how, and of course the wiles, will hit the geological jackpot.